This is Pastor David Blunt. I want to thank you for joining our YouTube channel today. If it's a blessing to you, I want to encourage you to like it, turn on the notification and subscribe button. If you're in the St. Louis area, I want to personally invite you to come out and join us every Sunday at 9 or 11, or our Spanish service at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Never forget, God is for you.
Welcome to Church on the Run Church, and we're excited to be in the house of God. Why don't you, right there where you're at, just give the best praise and worship this morning to Jesus. I think we all know this one is in the middle of it. Oh, let's all sing it together. He is jealous of love like you. Out to you. and say, I love you. I love you. Oh, how I love you. Oh, how I love you. Oh, how I love you. I want to take just a few seconds. Grace me for all men.
Our prayer.
trust me, nothing you've given more than I deserve. I offer you a love that's burning, only because you love me first. I will not.
When we're in gratitude and praise, his presence just came in, right? And I'm just thankful that us can experience the love of God anytime, any day. But I don't know if some of you know some people that sometimes they don't know the love of God. They haven't feel it. They know it. And I think you and I know where he took us from, right? I love God because I know he loved me. He took me out of wherever I was, right? When I need him, he was there. He loved me. Somebody say, he loved me. Some of us really understand it. But there are some people that coming in legacy, our biggest time in our church, to pass down the legacy that God is for you. But not just that, coming into the holidays, Emmanuel, Jesus with us, right? People don't know that he loved him. And you and I can be that witness. You and I can be that person. So can we pray and come in agreement that those are families, neighborhoods, communities, church, schools, university, can experience the love of God, and God can use us to leave a legacy of love? Come on, let's pray all together. Somebody can pray for with me with that? All right, let's come together. Father God, we come right now together, God. We love you, God. We're grateful. Our hearts are thankful for your love, God. We know from where you have taken us, God. And you love us, God. You love us. You really love us. God, right now we come in agreement, believing, God, for those family members that don't know your love, for those that don't know your love around our schools, our workplace, God, our neighborhood, our nation, God, right now we present it. They need your love. They need to know that you love them, God. Father God, use us to be lights, to be in the right place at the right time, to share your love, God. We ask you right now that you use us, God, and that you help us from north, south, east, and west, God. Your wind of love surprises, and we can share it with others, God. God, we believe it, we declare it, and we're going to be the light to give love. In Jesus' name, everybody say it. Oh, no, I'm in Church on the Rock. Everybody say amen. Amen. Do you know he loves you, right? I really know he loves us, right? So you're going to do something different. You're going to get out of your comfort zone. You're going to go to four people. Don't stay those ones you always do it. Go to somebody different and tell them God is for you and he loves you. Can you do that? All right, and then let's watch some amazing video. Go ahead. Do it.
Hey, online family, let's meet and greet right now. Turn to someone at your watch party and tell them God is for you. Then jump in the live chat and tell someone there God is for you. We have so many cool people with us in chat this morning, and I'm so glad to see you all here. We've got Brittany, we've got Breeze, we've got Beth, we've got Lauren, we've got Lenoy, we've got Josiah. It's so good to see you all here, to be here together with you in service, growing in our faith, growing together as a family in God. And you know, we've had some amazing things going on here at Church on the Rock, and some amazing things coming up. Our team has put together some really cool videos to show you what God is doing in people's lives and what's going on. So let's watch them.
Welcome to Church on the Rock. My name is Roberta, and I serve with Creative Arts.
And my name is David Moreno, and I serve in CTR Español. And if you're here with us live,
online,
or through our VR,
or at the Metaverse, we're so glad you joined our family.
And if you're joining online, make sure to
click on the connect link, because we want to connect with you.
And another way you can connect with us is through our social media, which is Facebook,
Instagram,
or what's the next one?
TikTok.
Or YouTube at MyCOTR.
Right here at Church on a Rock, we're one big happy family that loves to serve one another. That's why we have Grow Track.
You can join our class live during our 11 a.m. service or on demand.
Where you're going to learn about our culture, values, and mission of Church on the Rock.
You can sign up for a class at any time.
If you would love to give today, either for tithes or offerings, there are several easy ways to do it.
You can give through a text message on our website or by mailing it in the giving box on the way out, cryptocurrency, stock, Cash App, or Apple Pay.
We would love to thank you for generosity and for your giving. You are making a difference. We're so thankful you were here with us today and part of our big happy family.
And if you're visiting us today, be sure to stop by the guest center in the lobby, because we have a special gift for you.
And our watch page.
Yes, our watch page is where you can watch this week's service again or one of Pastor's recent teachings.
We have a new tool for you to invite friends and family to Church on Rock.
You can pick up door hangers at our connection points to pass out in your community.
The door hangers have a card
for a complimentary coffee from the Rock Express.
Mark your calendars for November 20th.
We will be celebrating 39 years of ministry with Bishop Dale Bronner.
And check out our website for more details about our Legacy Weekend. Once again, we thank you for joining us today. And as always,
God is for you.
Before becoming a Church on the Rock, you know, was really struggling to find myself, my place of who I wanted to become in life, and was really just trying to figure out what the world was about. And I was very young at the time. I think I was 20, 21. And, you know, we were just struggling at the time, just trying to get through life and figure things out. And when I found Church on the Rock, you know, it really gave me that foundation. You know, when Pastor talks about helping people find who they are so they can go out and impact others, you know, that's truly what Church on the Rock helped me do. You know, through Church on the Rock, we, you know, obviously found Christ, and we gave our lives to Christ. Through Church on the Rock, we were given the tools and the resources to discover ourselves even more through assessments. We were able to explore ourselves through being able to serve in different ministries, and that allowed for us to be able to utilize skills that we didn't know that we had. On top of that, it built skills that we had and truly allowed for me to expand beyond, you know, what I knew of my own self. I have a unique position here as the Executive Vice President of Maxwell Leadership, and it truly is amazing. We're actually the largest leadership training company on the planet, led by the number one leadership guru in the world, John Maxwell. And, you know, this opportunity really came as a result of saying yes to learning first, of watching John Maxwell on a VHS at Church on the Rock. It continued by me stepping up and saying, hey, I'd like to be a part, and I'll facilitate some courses as well too. It continued by me stepping outside the church and becoming certified by John Maxwell. And, you know, I built a business utilizing those tools and resources. And over time, I did the exact same thing I did at the Church on the Rock. I began to serve the organization. Every single opportunity that they gave me to serve, I took that opportunity. And over time, that allowed for me to build relationships, open doors, and for them to see that, hey, my values line up with their values. My work ethic is the work ethic that they're looking for. And in 2020, the opportunity came that they asked for me to actually lead the organization, which was just absolutely amazing. When I think about the legacy of Church on the Rock, you know, it is what we like to call deep and wide. I mean, I think about just the people that I've had the opportunity to impact over the past, you know, 20 years. And had I not stepped foot in that door, there'd be many people around the world just from my touch alone. So now if we multiply that and we look at the reach that you have, we look at the reach that so many others that I know inside of Church on the Rock that have gone out to impact people, to add value to people's lives, it's just amazing. So Church on the Rock will always have a place in my heart, always have a place in my heart for gratitude of helping me become who I am, always have a place in my heart for creating that love and that fire for personal growth and development, for loving people, for adding value to people. All of that for me started right there at Church on the Rock.
Well, good morning, church family. How's everybody doing this morning? Are we blessed to be in the house of the Lord? Amen. Well, we want to take a moment and recognize all those that have served or are currently serving in our military. Would you just stand? We want to recognize you and pray a special blessing over you. Yeah. We thank God for you. And church, would you just stretch your hands towards those standing? Let's pray for them right now. Father, we thank you, God, for these amazing, brave men and women, God, that have laid their life down, God, in serving our country and protecting our freedoms here. God, we speak blessing upon them today, God. We speak increase upon them. We thank you that your favor is on them. We thank you, God, for healing their bodies if they need healing. We thank you for provision, for the vision that you've placed on the inside of them. We thank you for their families, God, being blessed. We thank you that, God, you're opening all the doors that they need in this season, God. And God, we thank you, God, that all the seeds that have been planted, God, have not been forgotten. But God, we thank you, God, for a great harvest in their life, God. God, as they've taken care of other people, God, we thank you, God, that you're taking care of their house, God. Taking care of their family, Lord. God, we thank you that their best days are ahead of them, not behind them. We declare, God, victory in their life And we thank you, God, that you're blessing them this day and next year in their life. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on, can we just give God some praise for them? Amen, amen. And we're really excited because next Sunday is Legacy Sunday. And you know, we're celebrating 39 years as a church. We have Bishop Bronner that's going to be here. But the day before, which is this upcoming Saturday, we have our Marketplace Ministry. And you say, well, what is that? It is a time of gathering completely different from a church service, but a gathering for entrepreneurs and business leaders and people that are coming up in their company that want to grow, want to develop, want to get better. And Bishop Bronner, I don't know if you know his history, but his entire family has a business, the Bronner Brothers, that's been in existence for 75 years. They have over 300 employees, and he's going to be speaking at the event. I just want to encourage you, if you haven't signed up, you need to sign up because we have a space is limited. There's only a few spots left. It's probably going to sell out today. But let's watch a video of Bishop Bronner right now.
Fear always says, what if? What if you do this and you get fired? What if you do this if you get and then you get sick? What if you do this and then you lose what you've got? But faith does not ask what if. Faith says, even if it costs me, even if I'm made to be uncomfortable, I'm going to obey God rather than man.
Are we blessed here at Church on the Rock? Pastor says, we're not trying to get something from you. We're trying to get something to you and be a blessing. So we encourage you to be a part of that this upcoming Saturday. Well, are you ready to give to the Lord this morning? Do I have any cheerful givers in the room? Oh, you are giving that 9 o'clock service a run for their money. All right. Let's go to the Word of God. In Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, it says, lean on and trust in and be confident in the Lord with all your heart and mind, and do not rely on your own insight or understanding. Verse 6, in all your ways, know, recognize, and acknowledge. I just want to thank you and commend you, Church on the Rock, because when every time you give, every time you sow, every time you give to kingdom builders, give to Israel, every time you tithe, you're acknowledging God. Look what it says, because there's a promise here. Look at this. It says, and he will direct and make straight plain your paths. Let's look in the Living Translation. It says, if you want favor with both God and man. Is that you? That's me. Come on, if that's you, say that's me. We want favor with God and man and reputation for good judgment and common sense. And look at this. Then trust the Lord completely. That's what we're doing when we tithe. Don't ever trust yourself. Verse 6. In everything you do, look at this. Put God first. Wow. And he will direct you and crown your efforts with success. I think of that crown. Where does a crown go? It goes on your head. God's going to not just give you good ideas. He's going to give you God ideas with everything that you put your hand to. I want to encourage you as a tither, you can believe for God to give you strategy. You can believe for God to give you right timing. You can believe for his favor and his guidance. When you give, you can trust and know that God has got you. He's got your family. He's got your finances. He's got your business. So all you have to do is just give in faith. So I just want to encourage you and thank you for being faithful in your tithe and offering. And we're about to do our confession. Let's believe big. Can we do that? All right, let's all say it together. Lord, we faithfully and cheerfully worship you with the giving of our tithe and offerings. We believe as we sow seed to establish the vision of your house, you will also establish ours. As a result of our giving, we thank you for raises increases, bonuses, gifts, canceled debt, and surprise checks in the mail. We bless you for blessing our health, giving us a sound mind and quality relationships. Now help us, God, to know you as the God who is for us and to help people discover your purpose for their life. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for your giving.
I'm
going, church. Don't stop. Hallelujah. We recognize you, God. We glorify you. We read in our one-year Bible this morning in Psalm 111. It says, I will praise the Lord in the assembly with my whole heart in the congregation. Can we just pray? Father, we thank you, Lord, for this morning, God. And we thank you for speaking to us and working in us. God, we thank you for anyone that needs a healing in their body. We thank you for healing them this morning, God. God, we thank you, Lord, that maybe someone came in without hope. We thank you, God, they're not leaving the same, God. But they're living full of your hope, full of your word, full of your wisdom, God. God, we thank you, God, that our lives are never going to be the same. God, as we get into the word of God, we thank you that the word changes us, God. We go from glory to glory, from triumph to triumph, from victory to victory. God, we thank you, God, that every time we come to church on the rock, we're never the same when we leave. But we're going out to the mission field to reach people that are lost, God. Help us, equip us to add value to others this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Come on, can we just give God some praise? Well, before you're seated, find a few people and say, God is using me to leave a legacy. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hey, I'm thrilled and honored and humble thinking about literally some of God's greatest generals have stood from the platform here at Church on the Rock. And to stand here, y'all pray for your boy this morning, because our pastors are so amazing, aren't they? We love them so much. And Pastor said something last week that I have not let go of when he said, legacy is not something that it's just that you leave with people, but it's something you leave in people. Woo. And I think about, man, every time I come in this building, I leave with something on the inside of me. I'm moving forward to execute and work it out. And I don't want to miss this by saying and pause for a second to think, 39 years ago, two great people of God, Pastor David and Pastor Kim Blunt, answered the call. Wow. And planted Church on the Rock. Wow. And 35 people showed up at the St. Peter's Public Library. Now to this, wow, to God be the glory. And I just want to say, to anything great comes a great servant that God's used. I just want to take a moment. Can we just give it up for our pastors and just say, thank you. Yeah. Wow, what an honor it is to be in the house. We have a big vision here at Church on the Rock, and it's so exciting. Just look around and you think, wow, look at God. If you ever get discouraged or you feel like your faith is just a little low, all you need to do is drive up on the campus and drive around a little bit. And look around and saying, if God could do that, I'm a part of that. I'm under that. God could do it in my family. God could do it in my friendships. God could do it in my business. Yeah, so we serve a big God, and I'm excited and thrilled to talk to you and continue on legacy. And this morning, I want to talk a little bit on the three ways to live a life of impact. The three ways to live a life of impact. And, you know, Judges chapter 2, you know, Joshua's generation was an amazing generation. They took the land, right? They you know, be strong and courageous, right? Joshua 1:8, it's one of my favorite verses. It's just amazing what Joshua did. The Bible says, though, in Judges chapter 2, that when after Joshua died off, there became another generation that did not know the Lord. Had no idea who God was or what God had done. And so when we think about legacy, it's about leaving an impact, leaving footprints for someone else to follow in our footsteps in the pathway to pursuing and seeking Jesus Christ. And I think about this morning, as we're getting into the Word, three things that you and I can do to apply. Because you know what? We're not just hearers here at Church on the Rock. Right? Matthew 7:24. It's the scripture that Pastor and Pastor Kim, when they got the vision for Church on the Rock, Matthew 7:24, that there was a man that built his life on sand. And when the storms came, the foundation blew, but there was another wise person who built their life on the rock. So when the storms came, when trouble came, when pain came, they were still standing no matter the storm. They were still standing. They were holding on. And you know what I love about Church on the Rock is we're not just hearers, we're doers. We're executors of the word. Yeah. And so this morning, I have three things that we all can do together in the journey of leaving a legacy and living a life of impact. And so if you want to go with me to Psalm 78, verse 1, we're going to start here. It says, "Oh, my people, listen to my teaching. Open your ears to what I'm saying. For I will show you lessons from our history. Stories handed down to us from former generations." I just want you to know, grandparent in the room, that you are important. Who you are so important. Parent in the room, you're so important. Student, young person in the room, you are so important. Because there are stories for us to pass to each other, to share with each other, handed down from former generations, and for us to learn. "I will reveal these truths to you so that you can describe these glorious deeds of Jehovah to your children and tell them about the mighty miracles he did. For he gave his laws," that's the word. We're the word church, right? We're a word church. "He gave his word to Israel and commanded our fathers to teach them to the children." Verse 6, "so that they would turn, could teach their children too. Thus his laws passed down from generation to generation. Verse 7. In this way," I love this right here, "each generation has been able to obey his laws and to set its hope anew on God and not forget of his glorious miracles." So I want to talk to you three things. Everybody say three things that we can do to make an impact and leave a legacy. Number one, y'all ready? Yes. All right, y'all hungry. Number one, grow in my learning. We can grow in our learning. Wow. I think it's part of our culture here. Do you know, as a staff, I'm so blessed. Our staff is so blessed because our pastor invests. We're always given books. They invest into us and give us books to get better, to grow. We have a lifelong learner mindset here at Church on the Rock. We haven't arrived, and that the biggest room in our life is the room for improvement, and that we could always get better. You know that we value the feedback to get better, to grow, to learn. And I love this because this is a mindset, a growth mindset, to be a lifelong learner, to grow in our learning. I remember Pastor a few years ago, I was sitting down in a mentor meeting with him, and he was sharing a story about how he went to go visit Dr. Cho of South Korea. And at the time, he's now in heaven, but at the time, he was pastoring the largest church in the world. And Pastor went to go see Dr. Cho, and so they got him a seat. He was in the front row with a bunch of pastors. Pastor was leaned in. He was just like you. He was leaned in. He had his Bible open. He had his notepad open. He was ready to receive. He was ready to catch everything from this service. He wants to learn. He wants to grow. I love that. Aren't you thankful for a leadership that's humble, that even though 39 years, they're still growing. They're still reading. They're still seeking. I'll tell you, that is such a blessing to me, to be under a leader that I can watch from afar and say, he's not just sitting, but he's still seeking. He's not just, oh, you know what? Because he could, but he's still after God. I just want to brag for a minute on Pastor. They could, but they never are coasting. They're always growing. They've got a podcast. They got a book. They're always, and that's just so contagious. You could catch that. And so pastor is doing the same thing, wanting to catch something from the pastor of the largest church in the world, Dr. Cho. And he's sitting down at the time, and he's sitting down, and he looks over to the corner of his eye. And there's a couple other pastors there, and they're like sleeping. Pastor kind of, hey, what's up? What's going on? And they're like, yeah, he told this story before. We've heard this story. He's told it like a million times. Pastor shared with me, well I've heard that story before, but maybe there's something for me to get out of it that I didn't get out of it the last time I heard it. See, he had a posture. He had a position. He was positioning himself to receive, to answer to God wanted to speak to him, and he was leaned in. And so as he heard the story, some were sleeping, but our pastor, thanks be to God, he was leaned in. He was okay. I'm gonna catch something, you know, because it may just be a principle. It could be the Spirit. You know, you can catch something upon the man of God as he's speaking. Look what Hosea chapter 4, verse 6 says. I will destroy my people because they're ignorant. You have refused to learn, so I will refuse to let you be my priest. What is that saying? Is that they were up for position. They were up to be trusted by God, but because their posture was incorrect, because their position was incorrect, they could not receive because they didn't want to learn. Now it says, so I refuse to let you be my priest. You have forgotten the teachings. Wait a minute. So that means at one point they knew, but they forgot. That's why our one-year Bible is so important, because sometimes we could just go through life and so many things happen to us, but then we're reminded, oh, but his word says this. Oh, but his word says that. Oh, I can get through this because what his word says. So then it says, you've forgotten the teachings of your God, so I will forget your children. Whoa, so we're talking about legacy. We're talking about inheritance. We're talking about how can we pass it on? How can we leave an impact, leave a legacy? And this right here, there are many that are losing because they're not learning. And just because you fail or just because you make a mistake, you can use that as a test study and a classroom to look and say, wow, I can learn this and I can learn that. We should squeeze every failure. We should learn from every mistake. We should take it and say, I'm going to grow from this. But not only when we just make mistakes, but also when our victories, we can learn from it and say, you know what? We won this, but we can learn. We could do a little better in this area. See, what it does is it creates a posture of humility. I heard someone say either be humble or be humbled. I'd rather be humble. How about you? I'd rather just stay humble in the posture of it rather than put myself in a position where I'm going to be in an undesirable situation. So having a posture of humility and having a posture of wanting to grow, having a posture of, you know what, I'm a lifelong learner and I want to be developed. And you know what, I don't have a spirit. You know, there's a song, a famous song that came out years ago. It said, you can't tell me nothing. What? That song right there is just so opposed to what the word of God says, right? But James chapter 1, verse 9 says, be slow to speak, quick, woo, quick to listen, how can I grow, how can I, you know, when I started asking myself about learning, where were areas in my life and people that I knew that where we stopped learning, and I started to think about this, that a lot of times we stop or our learning stunts or our growth is stunted by being hurt. I was thinking about this the other day. Me and my dad, we went to see my favorite team and my favorite player play a basketball game. Went to the stadium, super excited. I get to the arena. I look up on the screen and it says, My favorite player is hurt and injured and is unavailable to play. I was devastated because I knew at that point we were going to lose that game. We did lose the game too. But I thought about it for a second is just as much as a player is unavailable because they're hurt, I would submit to you, Church on the Rock, that a lot of Christians are unavailable because they've been hurt. They have gotten hurt in their life. And you know, we hear this a lot. Hurt people, they hurt people, right? And those wounds or those disappointments or that discouragement, or you prayed this and this didn't happen, and you thought this was going to be a certain way, but it turned out to be the opposite way. And there's hurt, and maybe someone said something or did something. I'm thinking of a time that I was younger in ministry. I was 21 years old in ministry, and not this church. I was in a different city and at this church, and this pastor was mad, and there was like a miscommunication, and so he got mad and told me I was worthless to the kingdom of God. Told me I was worthless. It crushed me. It was in front of all my friends, and it crushed me. I thought, he said, you're worthless to the kingdom of God. You know, I went home and I prayed for him. I prayed for him. I didn't want to, but I prayed for him because I got to be a doer of the word. So I prayed for him. And you know, God told me, go find out his favorite restaurant and get him a gift card. I said, God, that can't be you. That's got to be the devil. So I was obedient and I did it. I still remember the feeling just picking up the gift card, like he should be getting me a gift card. But you know what? God was working on me, right? So I get this gift card and I give it to him and I blessed him and he was so blessed and he acted like he never said what he said. But what I didn't realize is years later, I find out he was going through a divorce. His wife was having an affair on him and he was going through the hardest time of his life. And I learned that, you know what, if I want grace, I got to extend and give grace. I don't know what people are going through, but life is too important to walk in unforgiveness. Wow. So I was like, I'm going to be a lifelong learner. I'm going to learn through this process. I'm not going to allow it to get to me. I'm not going to allow it to destroy me. Some of you right now, you've been going through stuff because people have been saying things about you and you've been feeling and facing stuff. I just want to encourage you right now, put your eyes on Jesus. He's the author and the finisher of the faith. Man will fail you. People will fail you, but God will never fail you. Come on, praise break. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. So you and I, we if we want to leave an impact, we got to grow in our learning. You know, we have to be lifelong learners. You know, and I have a scripture to this because we're talking about hurt and how hurt can stunt us or stop us from growing. And I know what that's like because when you're hurt, you end up, if you're not careful, your heart will get hardened. But you want to know a way to not get offended? Y'all want to know? Oh, I got a scripture for you. That was kind of weak, but I'll let it go. Okay. Psalm 119, 165 says this, "Great peace have they who love your law. Nothing shall offend them or make them stumble." You know what that tells me is that the more I have a hunger for God, this is going to help me. So the longer I have a hunger for God, I can't get offended. I'm too much in the word of God. It doesn't matter what's being said. I'm just going to focus on the word. I can't be a victim when I'm in the word of God. Victory is always in my future when I'm seeking God's word. So I would submit to you that if you're dealing with hurt today, you know what the Bible says? He sent his word and it healed them. What is that saying? That all I got to do is get my one-year Bible. All I got to do is get in my Proverbs, get in my Psalms. And you know what? Well, Mark, I'm hurting. I'm feeling hurt. I'm dealing with hurt. All I got to do is be a lifelong learner. All I got to do is have a great hunger. I would submit to you that your hunger may be the answer to your healing. If you just get a hunger for God, you'll find and say, wait a second, I don't feel this anymore. God will bring healing on your emotions. He'll bring healing to that mind. He'll bring healing to that past where you're not looking backwards, you're looking forward. Because God never leads you backward. He leads you forward. Right? So you walk in the forgiveness and the grace of God and say, if God's extending me grace, I'm going to give them grace. I'm not going to be easily offended, but I'm going to respond with what does the word say? Let's look at the next scripture. Proverbs 18:15. This is a paraphrase. It says, the spiritually hungry are always ready to learn more. Wow. I love this. For their hearts are eager to discover new truths. You and I, that's what we do in our one-year Bible. That's what we do in our Bible plan. That's what we do when we seek God. We just get hungry, and we're not fazed by what the world says. We're not fazed by what the doctor says. We're not fazed by what the lawyer says. We're not fazed by what the bill says. All we're doing is being moved by the word of God, and we're not going to be offended. We're just going to be lifelong learners. I'm growing through it. We're going to grow together. Yeah, that's the attitude and the posture. So number one, grow in my learning. Number two would be grow in my example. Wow, grow in my example. There's a scripture for that. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5, it says, I remember your genuine faith, for you share the faith that was first filled in your grandmother Louise and your mother Eunice. And I know that the same faith continues strong in you. I love about our churches is that we're not a one-generation church. We're a multi-generation church. We serve the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We got grandparents and parents and students and young adults all in the room. I love this, though, because do you know that the Apostle Paul is trying to point out something, that it's important that it doesn't skip a generation. It's important that it goes from generation to generation. I want to commend you on bringing your kids to church. I want to commend you bringing your students to youth. I want to commend you grandparents that are like, you know what, the mom's not doing, I'm bringing it. I just want to commend you because everything you're doing is not in vain. Woo. What it's doing is leaving an impact. Oh, this right here is so key, because a lot of people get hung up and say, well, but I didn't have a Louise or a Eunice. It's just me. In fact, when you hear the word legacy, it actually kind of shakes you, because you think about maybe some negative things in the past from your family. Maybe for you, it's just, those generational curses and things that were passed down that were undesirable. But I want to encourage you this morning that it could start with you to leave a legacy. It could start with you. It's never too late. And even though it ran in your family, until it ran into you, it's when it stops. That perversion, that addiction, that victim mindset, that blaming spirit, all of that can stop with you. You know what? It's not coming in my house. As for me and my house and the future generations, we will serve the Lord. When we have that mindset, it changes everything. So there has to be an example. There has to be an example. We have to be able to pass down. And I learned that some things are taught, but a lot of things are caught. You know, when I first got to Church in the Rock, before I came on staff, the number one thing that I wanted to know about Pastor Blunt, I was anointed teacher, anointed minister, but the number one thing I wanted to know about him is his family. I wanted to see what they were like outside of here. And when I saw no one's perfect, but I'm just telling you, when I saw what the anointing that was on his family and how he fathered and his sons, and I saw the way they treated people, I said, I want to be linked up with something like that. My future, I just want to encourage you in this room. You may have not had physical family, but you got spiritual family. That every time you come in here, you can catch the anointing. My dad didn't do it. Well, you got a spiritual father. Well, my mom didn't. You got a spiritual mother. You can catch that prayer spirit on Pastor Kim. You can catch that anointing. Well, they didn't pray for me yet, but you're here and you're receiving and you're going to pass it down to the next generation. Yeah. I was a while back, a few years ago, I was watching, I was just blowing some time. I was on an airplane and I was watching this Shark Week I don't know why. Y'all don't have no idea. But I was watching these surfers and what they're doing and all these different moves. And it got into this whole thing where this young man named Sean, he was in a competition and ends up that two great white sharks go after him while he's surfing in a competition. And it's this miraculous story because he survives and only gets a little bite on his leg. And it's this amazing story. And I'm like, wow, well, that's just amazing. Right? So I'm watching it. And then they go and they're doing another story. So the story is over. Then I go to another story. So I go to the other story. And it's a different surfer. It's a different competition about 25 miles down the coast, a different area. And same situation. I'm like, man, this is all these sharks. This is scaring me. So the same situation, but it's one great white shark that goes right after and starts to attack this surfer. But seconds later, the guy from the previous story, Sean, is surfing, gets up to where he's at, punches the shark. I'm like, you can't make this stuff up. This is crazy. But and rescues the other surfer. They all come out alive. No one gets injured. And they interviewed Sean after it. And I was just thinking, like, yo, if you get bit by a shark, you might want to check out a new hobby. Like, maybe it's time to start golfing. Maybe it's time to start playing volleyball. Maybe just stay out of the ocean, you know? They said, why did you go out there? Why were you there? He said, because I never wanted anyone to experience what I experienced alone. And I thought about it. Young person, grandparent, parent in this room, there are things that we experience and deal with and face, but we can be an example to show someone else. Hey, you don't gotta deal with that alone. Hey, you're fighting this situation. You're fighting stuff on your identity. You're fighting stuff about the peer pressure. You're fighting stuff on alcohol or drugs. Hey, you know what? I got through that. We can get through that together. Let's fight together. Come on, I'm going to show you how I got through it. It's amazing how many people will hear and watch when you don't know that they're hearing and watching. That they're catching something that's on your life. It's amazing that there are things that you can catch from other people from afar. That's why we have to be lifelong learners, because there's books that you can catch. There's anointings that you can catch. That's why the posture and position is so important, because there are things for us to catch, for us to accelerate our growth so that we can leave an impact. I would just encourage you in this room, don't underestimate the impact that you are making, because people are watching. Don't underestimate it. I was just a few years ago, my wife and I, right before we had our son, he's 6 years old, and right before we had our son, my mom came in town. She lives in Charlotte, and so she came in town. She's visiting, and we had to put together our crib for our little boy, and I'm going to put it together, and I just be honest with y'all, I'm construction challenged, all right, y'all? Putting things together is not good. I had that crib did not look like a crib. My mom's looking at me kind of like, and I'm now feeling bad, like, mom, I'm a good parent. I could do this. So I did what any smart millennial would do. I pulled out my phone. I went to YouTube. I found the model. And it showed me how to do it. Because those nuts and those bolts and those pieces and those places and what they're calling it, I wasn't figuring it out. But when I saw someone else do it, oh, we had it done in just a moment. Let me just encourage you how important your example is. And when you grow in your example, because all you have to do is just be honest and transparent. And when people see you're going through a storm, don't hide that storm. Oh, you know what? There's no greatness in fakeness. And you know what? If you want transformation, you have to be transparent. So what we can do, you and I together, is say, hey, yeah, the rent is due, and yeah, I'm $1,000 short, but God is still God. And if he brought me through that, He can bring me through. He brought me through this. You start stirring, and what? People are catching something. They're hearing something. Your kids are hearing something. Your family, your coworkers are hearing something. They're watching you through the storm, and then they're thinking, if they got through the storm, I can get through the storm. I can get through it. What? So your example speaks so loud. I just encourage you this morning to, we want to grow in our learning. We want to grow in our example. And then number three, we want to grow in our giving. And before I talk about giving, I just felt led this morning when I was praying that, you know, the word give and the word forward, the first three letters of moving forward, right, is four. Forgive. We can't move forward till we forgive. We can't move forward till we forgive. And some of us, we just have to let it go so that we can open the door to receive what God has for us. Let me just encourage you. You're in this room and you're dealing with things. That forgiveness brings freedom. That forgiveness will bring you out and help you. And sometimes when people hear you forgave them, you showed them respect when they didn't show you respect. You honored them when they didn't honor you. Do you see that you're living scripture? They don't have to read it. They're reading your life. They're seeing you demonstrate the word of God. The Apostle Paul said it's not by enticing words of wisdom, but it's by power and demonstration. I just encourage you can demonstrate that by loving and moving forward. So number one, we talked about growing in our learning. Number two, we talked about growing in our example. Then number three, as we're closing, growing in our giving. Wow, let's look at this. We read this verse, but I want to highlight something and go back to it. For he gave his laws, so God so loved the world, he gave, and then he gave us the scripture. He gave us laws and commanded our fathers to teach them to the children. In this way, each generation has been able. So it does take obedience. It does take obedience. Someone said, the instruction you choose to obey will determine the future you create. So it does take obedience. So when you step out and you obey, in this way, each generation has been able to obey his laws to set up his hope, a new God, and not forget his glorious miracles. So A would be sharing. What am I giving? I'm sharing my faith. I'm sharing what God's doing. I'm sharing how much he loves me. I'm sharing how I went through this battle and God brought me through. You never know who's catching. You never know who's listening. You never know who's in the break room. You never know who could just hear as you're bragging on God, as you're talking about what God's done, as you're sharing. Never stop sharing. Well, they're not listening. You know, it's always too soon to quit. Never give up on your family. Never give up on your extended family. Never give up on your coworkers. Just keep being faithful. Just keep sharing. Just keep being obedient. You know, that blessing follows obedience. So all our job is not to save anyone. Our job is to be obedient, and God does the saving. God that brings the increase. God brings the blessing. All right, and then the next one, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. Teach those who are rich in this world and not to be proud and not to trust in their money, which is so unreliable. Their trust should be in God. Oh, I love that. Who richly gives us all we need for our enjoyment. God wants us to be happy. God wants us to enjoy life. I love that. But look what it says. Tell them to use their money to do good. Wow, I just want to say thank you, Church in the Rock, because your faithfulness, because of your sowing. I just think about it in this room. Look in this room, the seats that are in this room. Somebody gave ahead, saw the vision. Somebody sacrificed. We wouldn't be in this building if it wasn't for people that were obedient, that heard the call, that gave ahead, that saw in something that was bigger than just themselves, but in a local community that's making a difference from locally, but also globally, from on TV to Israel, to missions, to Puerto Rico, all the things that are happening in our metaverse, all is happening because of your faithfulness of giving. But listen, it says, then should be rich in good works and generous good works. Thank God for our dream team. Thank God for volunteers that will step out and serve. If you're not a part of our dream team, I just want to invite you to get a part, get in growth track, start serving. There is something that will come out of you that you don't even realize that's on the inside of you the moment you begin to serve. And good works and generous to those in need, always being ready, there it is again, to share with others. So, verse 19, by this, doing this, they'll be storing up their treasure as good foundation for the future. Isn't that awesome right there? That as I'm sowing, as I'm serving, as I'm sharing, I'm storing up good foundation for the future. God has my future because he has my present. Wow, he's got me right now, so I don't have to worry about tomorrow. Look what it says right here. So A was sharing, B was serving, and then C is sowing. Look at this last verse right here. They shared freely and give generously to those in need. Their good deeds, wow, will be remembered forever. Wow, they will have influence and honor. That's you, that's us, Church in the Rock. That your faithfulness, I want to encourage you, next week it's legacy, our legacy offering, and I want to encourage you to pray about giving to that. It's not about the amount, it's about the equal sacrifice. Amounts will be different, but us sacrificing and giving ahead as we believe God for what he's going to do. Think about the people that did it for this building. I'm thinking about the things that we're going to do in the future. You know, our best days are ahead of us, yes, as a church. So I want to encourage you to pray about that. And I want to encourage you that as we are lifelong learners, as we grow in our example and as we grow in our giving, we can leave an impact. I'm done. Did you receive something this morning? Give God praise for his word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Would you just bow your heads and close your eyes with heads bowed and eyes closed? You're in this room and you've never accepted Jesus into your life, or maybe for you, when we talked about hurt, you were growing, you were on fire, God was doing something, but then some things happened. Hurt came in. And maybe you feel far away from God, but today, after hearing the word of God, you're ready to walk in healing. You're ready to be a doer of the word. You're ready to start making an impact. You're ready to start following Jesus. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. I'm not going to call anyone out. I'm not going to embarrass anybody, but I am going to give you an opportunity to make a decision. Why wait another day not serving God when you can start today and begin serving God and watch God do something that impacts your life and impacts the lives around you? With heads bowed, eyes closed, if that's you, would you just raise your hand right where you are? Not going to call you out, not going to embarrass you. You see that hand? I see that hand. Yeah. Hands are going up all over. If you're watching online, just punch the button right on the screen and let us know you're making a decision. All right, church family, let's all pray with those that are making a decision here and online. Say, Heavenly Father, I repent. I believe you sent Jesus Christ to die for me and he rose again. Jesus, I make you my Lord and my Savior. Take my life and make an impact. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on, can we just give God some praise in this room?
This is Pastor David Blatt. I want to thank you for joining our YouTube channel today. If it's a blessing to you, I want to encourage you to like it, turn on the notification, and subscribe button. If you're in the St. Louis area, I want to personally invite you to come out and join us every Sunday at 9 or 11, or our Spanish service at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Never forget, God is for you.